ना सोई, सट सुध रही सट संगति पाई, पारस परस कुहात सुहाई, राम सिया राम सिया राम जन राम, राम सिया राम सिया राम जय जय राम. दिस मीन्स विदाउट सत्संग देर इज नो कॉन्शियंस, एंड विदाउट द ग्रेस ऑफ राम वन डज नॉट गेट सत्संग. सत्संगति इज अ रूट ऑफ ब्लिस एंड वेल बींग. द विकेड ऑल्सो इम्प्रूव बाई गेटिंग सत्संगति, as iron becomes beautiful like gold at the touch of a philosopher. This is a legend promising that the good shall always prevail over evil. This is a tale of sacrifice and courage. This is the epitome of knowledge and morals. This is not just another story. This is Ramayana. A very good afternoon and Jai Hind to one and all present here. From one generation to another, and centuries after centuries, Ramayana has served the followers of Hinduism as a guide for leading a virtuous life and help leaders to follow the path of Dharma. The scripture embodies the sacrifices of Lord Ram and Goddess Sita as they follow the path of righteousness, eventually destroying the demon king Ravan and establishing the everlasting victory of good over evil. Today's event is an effort to keep the spirit of celebration intact in our very own Sunbeam style. So, on the behalf of Sunbeam College, Varna, I, Divya Chaudhary, along with my co-host, Ms. Smriti Pandey, welcome you all to the Ramayana Festival, an inter-college literary festival organized by Ehtiraq, the literary club. As we are virtually connected, sincere apologies in advance as we experience any technical glitches in between. In the series of competition, the event of prominence today is Vyakhyan, the speech competition. This contest is organized to serve as a platform for young orators to showcase their art of articulation along with their understanding of the epic. Before we commence, to grace the event, we have amongst us respected Principal Sir, Dr. Rajiv Singh, respected Administrator Ma'am, Dr. Shalini Singh, and our esteemed judge. Now, I'd like to invite Dr. Shalini Singh, Ma'am, to share a few words of wisdom.
Good afternoon and Jai Hind, everyone. I extend a warm welcome to our judge, Dr. Priyanka Srivastava. Thank you, Dr. Priyanka, for accepting our invitation. I would also like to congratulate and welcome all the participants who are there from different colleges, different part of the country. We are pleased to share that we have participants from Delhi, Dehradun, Pune, Chennai, and many more cities. I would like to congratulate the students of Literary Club who took such a great initiative of organizing a Ramayana Festival. Why Ramayana Festival? Because Ramayana has an important influence on Sanskrit poetry and Hindu life and culture. And that is why, to honor our culture and taking you all back to our roots, we thought of organizing such festival. So once again, I congratulate everyone. And once again, I extend my warm welcome to our judge and different participants. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Today's competition will be judged by Dr. Priyanka Srivastava. Dr. Priyanka Srivastava is currently working as an assistant professor at Agrasen Kanya PG College, Varanasi, since 2002. She is also an English counselor in Indira Gandhi National Open University. She has participated and presented papers in various seminars and national conferences. Her articles have been published in various national and international journals. Now, I would request Dr. Priyanka Srivastava ma'am to address the gathering.
respected principal sir, administrator ma'am, president of the event, Miss Smriti Pandey, and club in charge, Dr. Deepti Agrawal. First of all, I would like to congratulate the organizing team behind this event for organizing such an insightful and valuable topic, means event on the valuable topic on the Ramayana. The Ramayana, as most of us know, as an ancient epic, which is based on the towering character of Lord Rama, along with its his opponent, who is same in a stature known as the Ravana, but which is composed by Maharshi Valmiki. But it is not mere a long heroic poem having 24,000 shlokas and divided into 500 cantos and 7 books. It is an institution which shows the right path to lead life. It puts forth the Sanatani culture of Hindus. The Ramayana is the record of the journey to goodness. Because Ram here stands for Lord Rama, it is made up of two words, Ram and Ayana. Ayana stands for journey. So here we have the journey towards goodness of Lord Rama. The message it gives that the virtuous is victorious and vicious is punished. It is actually based on the code of conduct, human values, and concept of dharma. If we see the word dharma, we know its religious meaning, but dharma actually stands for the deed, the responsibility we should take for society, we should take for the family, we should take for the nation, and also for the globe. Here, what to say, that each and every prominent character of Ramayana gives some moral teaching. If we take the towering character of Lord Rama, he symbolizes sacrifice, selflessness, loyalty for his wife, love for and respect for the parents and siblings. Mata Sita symbolizes love, loyalty, and sacrifice, as well as hope. Here we have the sibling bonding also. All the brothers lived in unity through thick and thin. Hanumanji is also the symbol of his devotion towards his master. So at present, we are lacking all these things. We are living into the world where things fall apart. We have forgotten all our values, moralities, responsibilities, and code of conduct, and totally been disconnected with our Sanatani Sabhyata. So, and today it is a need to connect our youth to our Sanatani culture, Sanatani Sabhyata. And I think this program based on the Ramayana is a true effort connecting youth to our Sanatani Sabhyata. So core of conduct, which is the core of the Ramayana, needs to be followed by modern society. Thank you. It's all over with me. And all the very best to all the participants of the Vyakhyan. And I'm very sure that it is going to be very beneficial to all of us. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your kind words. We are truly honored to have you amongst us.
Over to Smriti.
Good afternoon and Jai Hind, everyone. I'm Smriti Pandey, president of Ehtiraag, the literary club of Sunbeam Women's College, Varuna. I once again welcome each one of you to the Ramayan Festival. The aim behind the Ramayan Festival was simple, to celebrate Ramayan. And we did that through some astounding art, excellent proses and poems, and yes, by the mesmerizing chaupais by our participants. Let's have a look at all the events that were conducted. We had Ramayan Lake Youth, a writing competition. Here, participants were supposed to write their pieces, it could have been prose or poems, on the topic Valmiki Ramayan, Paristhitik or Paryavaraniya Sadbhav Par Iska Vichar, Valmiki Ramayan, its thought on ecological and environmental harmony. We had allowed participants to write in Hindi or English, and there was a limit of words, which was 600 words. The next event that we had was Can we have the next slide, please, sir? The next event that we had was Ramayan Chitran, wherein participants were requested to send art depicting a scene or a character from Ramayan. And we did receive an overwhelming response for this event. We thank each of our participants for their amazing art submissions. The next that was there for the Ramayan Festival was Ramayan Chaupai, which was a recitation event. In this, participants were asked to recite a chaupai from Ramcharitramanas along with its explanation. They were marked on adherence to theme, originality, clarity, pace and punctuation, as well as modulation. The last of all the events is Ramayan Vyakhyan, which will be conducted very shortly online. Here, participants have been already given a topic, Ramayan mein dharma ka niyam, iske mahatva aur aadhunik samay mein prabhav, the law of dharma in Ramayan, its significance and impact in modern times. Speech can be given in Hindi or English. We will be conducting this event very shortly.
Smriti, just a second. Just a second. We have our deputy director amongst us. We welcome you, ma'am.
Ma'am, it's indeed an honor to have you amongst us. Can we request you to please address the virtual gathering of our participants and our audience?
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's an absolute honor for me to be here. And I was so amazed at the participation list. We've got some of the best colleges in the country who have decided to participate in this very, very interesting event, Vyakhyan. So Vyakhyan obviously means to express, to speak, to say something. And the very fact that we have a topic like Ramayan, I think is absolutely amazing, because I've been very intrigued by the Ramayan as an epic myself. I think one of the most beautiful relationships have been expressed in Ramayan. The ideal relationships have been expressed by Ramayan. Those of you who have also read different versions on the Ramayan about the life of Ram, about the fact that he was somebody who believed in writing down the law, someone who believed a person should always follow the law and the rules, and that things are always black and white. He never believed in gray areas at all. That is why, in fact, he even questioned his wife. That can be very controversial. Of course, that's a different issue. But at the same time, it also shows that we have to be law-abiding citizens. And I think it's very important that we're doing this for college-going students, because this is the time when you people are getting embroiled, and I would say it's your formative stage of your life, and you're being trained as to how, in a society, if each one of y'all mind your own laws, follow your own laws, don't transgress it, you don't come into anybody else's area, and society would actually be so much more smooth. So with that, I want to really congratulate Shalini ma'am, her complete team, Rajiv sir, Ram sir, Shubhkamna, all the teachers, so many students who worked very, very hard to come up with this idea, to prepare their own children with this thought, and also the fact that we've invited and managed to get so many colleges together. I think this online platform has made exchange of ideas so much easier across the globe. So with that, I wish Vyakhyan all the best. And I loved your topic. Keep going on it. And as you keep speaking, writing, you keep talking about the shlokas of Ramayan in the Chaupai program, you must actually make this as a way of life. Only then will the purpose be achieved. Once again, all the best. Congratulations to the team. Thank you, and Jai Hind.
Thanks a lot, ma'am, for the appreciation and your best wishes. And as ma'am said, we did receive an overwhelming participation from different colleges of India. And now it's time to have a look at all the colleges that have joined us for this event today. We had Kirori Mal College, Delhi University, Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur Khalsa College, University of Delhi, Sinbeam College for Women, Bhagwanpur, Varanasi, Sri Agrasen Kanya PG College, Varanasi, Sinbeam Women's College, Varuna, Varanasi, Motilal Nehru College, Delhi University, MIT Academy of Engineering, Pune, DAV PG College, Dehradun, Birla Institute of Technology, Misra, Mount Carmel College, Bangalore, Vellore Institute of Technology, Chennai, Harish Chandra PG College, Varanasi, Sri Ganesh Rai PG College, Sidhauni, Janki Devi Memorial College, Delhi University, and Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. Now, we hereby announce the commencement of the fourth event, Ramayan Vyakhyan, an online speech competition. I would speak up the rules for this event. Participants are requested to pay attention. Participants have been given to speak on the following topic. Ramayan mein dharm ka niyam, iske mahatv aur aadhunik samay mein prabhav. The law of dharm in Ramayan, its significance and impact in modern times. Speech can be given in Hindi or English. Maximum time limit of speech is 3 minutes. The speech should be of at least 1.5 minutes and should not extend the maximum time limit, that is of 3 minutes. There will be a negative marking of 5 points for non-adherence to time limit. All the participants must keep their audios on mute until and unless they are called out. The results of the judge would be final. Here's the judging criteria. Adherence to theme, clarity of speech, originality of content, articulation and modulation, creativity and confidence. We now begin with Ramayan Vyakhyan, an online speech competition. I would now request our first participant, Mr. Aditya Mishra from Motilal Nehru College, Delhi University, to unmute himself and deliver his speech. I just request the host to kindly keep a check at the waiting room because people are sending texts regarding the same. I'll move on to the next participant, Mr. Mayank Tiwari, Kirori Mal College, Delhi University. Next, we have Ms. Yashi, Kirori Mal College, Delhi University. Kindly unmute yourself and deliver your speech.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, so timing ka pata kaise chalega? Like you will give the wave or what?
You can start. I will give you a signal for that. And we will not be giving you any warning bell for that. We'll just notify you about your total time limit. So Ms. Okay. Yashi, your time starts. Yeah, do you have any?
Wait a minute. Okay, let me set up one second.
Sure. Till then, I just request all the other participants of Ramayan Vyakhyan, whenever you join, please drop a message in the chat box so that we receive a confirmation and proof of your attendance. Are you ready?
Wait a minute. Okay, let me start my timer once a minute.
Sure, you can do that.
So, can I start?
Yes, your time starts.
One, two, three, start. सदंती गरिमा को मेरा सादर नमन। आज का विषय कि रामायण में धन का नियम, इसके महत्व, आधुनिक समय में प्रभाव। तो सबसे पहले समझने की आवश्यकता है कि रामायण एक ऐसा व्याख्यान जो हमें धर्म के बारे में सिखाता है। धर्म केवल धार्मिक व्याख्यान नहीं, अपितु हमारे जीवन जीने की शैली, जहां हम जानते हैं कि हमें क्या करना चाहिए, क्या नहीं करना चाहिए। यूं तो रामायण का हर शख्स, हर कैरेक्टर और हर पहलू हमें कुछ ना कुछ शिक्षा देता है, लेकिन समय के अभाव के कारण हम कुछ पर ध्यान केंद्रित करेंगे। कहा जाता है कि रघुकुल रीत सदा चल्याई, प्राण जाए पर वचन न जाए। महोदय, यहाँ पे जब हम देखते हैं कि जो दशरथ हैं वे अपने प्राण से भी प्यारे पुत्र को वानप्रस्थ भेज देते हैं, क्यों? क्योंकि उन्हें अपने वचन का पालन करना होता है। और जब आज के समय में हम इसकी आवश्यकता देखते हैं तो हमें समझना होगा कि किस प्रकार से आज विश्वास की कमी होती जा रही है। हम किसी पे विश्वास नहीं करते हैं क्योंकि हम वचन के प्रति अपने अमूल नहीं है। दूसरों के वचन की बात करें, हम खुद से किए हुए वादे तोड़ देते हैं, जिसके कारण जो आज का युवा है जो सफलता की राह पर बढ़ सकता है वह खुद संघर्ष करता है। वहीं जहां राम के द्वारा आज्ञा पालन की बात की जाती है, तो वर्तमान समय में हमें वृद्ध आश्रम देखने को मिलते हैं, जो कि हमें बताता है कि किस प्रकार से रामायण का महत्व और अधिक बढ़ जाता है। जहां रावण ने अपनी बहन के अपमान के बदले के लिए सीता का अपहरण किया, लेकिन उनकी आज्ञा के बिना उन्हें कभी स्पर्श भी नहीं करा, वहीं हमें उदाहरण मिलता है आज के हाथरस जैसे कांड का, जहां हमें समझने की आवश्यकता है कि किस प्रकार से हमारे मूल्य खत्म होते जा रहे हैं। उन मूल्यों को अगर हम अपनाएं तो यहाँ रामायण का महत्व अपने आप ही बढ़ जाता है, आधुनिक समय में उसका प्रभाव हमें देखने को मिलेगा। जहां शबरी ने निरंतर प्रयास किया, जो आज के समय की प्रतियोगिता की आवश्यकता है कि इस प्रतियोगिता के जगत में आपको निरंतर प्रयास करके आगे बढ़ना चाहिए, और साथ में जो राम है वे सफलता के आगे, अब सफलता की सुई के आगे भी घमंड ना होने का उदाहरण प्रस्तुत करते हैं। इसी से समझ में आता है कि आज के समय में कितनी आवश्यकता इस चीज की बढ़ चुकी है। जहां विभीषण सत्य की ओर आगे बढ़ते हुए, केवल सत्य का पालन करते हुए अपने भाई को छोड़ देते हैं, और हमें आधुनिक समय में भाई भतीजावाद से जूझना पड़ता है, तो यहीं पे इसकी आवश्यकता, इसका महत्व और अधिक बढ़ जाता है। महोदय, इसी के साथ समझने की आवश्यकता है, जब रामायण में राम ने रावण का अंत कर दिया था, तब वे लक्ष्मण से कहते हैं कि रावण एक प्रकांड पंडित था, ज्ञानी था, आप जाइए और उससे ज्ञान लेकर आइए। महोदय, हर प्रकार के ज्ञान का सम्मान आवश्यक होता है। जहाँ ज्ञान के सम्मान होता है, वहीं पे हमारे मूल्य आगे उठ पाते हैं, जिससे हमें समझने की आवश्यकता है कि आज के समय में किस प्रकार से हम किसी को भी लज्जित कर देते हैं, जहां से हमारे मूल्यों का हनन होना शुरू होता है। जहां हम बात करते हैं कि राम राज्य में जो राजधर्म है वह सर्वोपरि है, जहां उन्होंने केवल अपना मोह ही नहीं त्यागा, भगवान राम ने सीता को छोड़ा भी, तो सीता ने जहां नारी सशक्तिकरण और मूक रहते हुए भी किस प्रकार से अंत में वे विद्रोह करती हैं, यह हमें दिखाती हैं कि किस प्रकार से नारी सशक्तिकरण जैसी जो व्याख्यान है वह रामायण में हमें देखने को मिलती है। रामायण के हर पहलू, हर कैरेक्टर से हमें कुछ ना कुछ सीखने को मिलता है, और उसी के कुछ उदाहरण मैंने यहाँ आपके सामने पेश करे। तो यहीं पर समझने की आवश्यकता है कि किस तरह से रामायण का हर धर्म, हर नियम हमें बताता है कि किस प्रकार से आज के समय में हमें उसे पालन करना चाहिए और उसका महत्व क्या है। इसी के साथ अपने समय की समाप्ति के साथ मैं अपने विचार यहीं समाप्त करती हूँ। धन्यवाद। I guess I was on time.
I request Divya to kindly the time. Oh, thank you, Smriti. Ma'am, your time limit exceeded by 11 seconds. It was 3 minutes, 11 seconds.
So, I was waiting for your wave, as you have said that you will inform, but you haven't.
Here's a clarification for all the participants. We will be only telling you that your time starts now. We will not be telling you about the time when your time limit is up. We will only be informing you about the total time you have taken, because we don't want to interrupt our participants while they are delivering their speeches. Moving on to the next participant, Mayank Tiwari. I just called out your name and it seems you have joined now. Mayank Tiwari, Kirorimal College, Delhi University. Are you present?
Yeah, I'm present, ma'am.
I request you to kindly unmute yourself and deliver your speech. Your time starts now.
Okay, but can you give me 10 seconds more? Actually, I reset my time. Yeah, okay. So I start?
Your time starts now.
Okay. Sadan ko naman. Upasthit sabhi logon ko vishay ka mantavya bata hai. कि रामायण में धर्म का विषय एवं इसकी प्रासंगिकता। रामायण मूलतः सत्य पर आश्रित है। सत्यमेश्वरो सत्य सत्यमेश्वरो लोके सत्यम धर्माश्रिता सत्य मूलानि सर्वाणि सत्यम नास्ति परम पदम। मूलभूत से सत्य क्या है? सत्य का द्योतक केवल एकमात्र स्थिति नहीं है, सत्य का तात्पर्य है आपकी ईमानदारी से, सत्य का तात्पर्य है आपकी वस्तुनिष्ठता से। रामायण में तमाम ऐसे प्रसंग आए हैं जिनमें कुछ मर्यादित रहे हैं, कुछ अमर्यादित रहे हैं, किंतु जब संपूर्ण रामायण की बात की जाती है तो उसके मूलभूत जो नायक रहे हैं श्री राम और नायिका सीता, उनके द्वारा अनेक ऐसे उद्धरण एवं उदाहरण हमें मिलते हैं जिनकी प्रासंगिकता आज भी सिद्ध होती है। मैं यह कहता हूं कि सारी की सारी चीजें आज प्रासंगिक नहीं है, किंतु अधिकांश चीजें प्रासंगिक है, यथा धैर्य का होना। कैसा धैर्य? राम से मिलने के लिए चाहे श्रृंगेर बेरपुर का राजा जो एक नाव चालक था, या चाहे सबरी, या चाहे अहिल्या का उनके चरणों से तर जाने पर पुनः स्त्री रूप में प्राप्त करना, या धैर्य के वहां उदाहरण रहे हैं। धैर्य का दूसरा उदाहरण हमें श्री राम के द्वारा ही मिलता है कि किस प्रकार वो समंदर पार करने से पूर्व समुद्र की पूजा करते हैं रामेश्वरम का एक लिंग बनाकर, या भी एक धैर्य का उदाहरण मिलता है। दूसरी बात है स्त्रियों के प्रति सम्मान रखना, जो कि हमें रावण से भी मिलता है, अधिकांश तौर पे नहीं लेकिन रावण की भी यथा स्थिति से हमें प्राप्त होता है कि किस प्रकार वह एक अपहरण करता तो था लेकिन व्यभिचारी नहीं था। आज के समय में व्यभिचार हमें तमाम जगहों पे दिख रहा है, रावण व्यभिचारी नहीं था। श्री राम एक पत्नी व्रत के पालक थे। आज तमाम ऐसे धर्म है या तमाम जगहों पे ऐसी न्याय विधि नियमावली लगाई गई है जहां पे वह कई शादियां कर सकते हैं, क्यों? क्योंकि उनके धर्म ग्रंथ में लिखा है। लेकिन राम सत्य संकल्पित एक पत्नी व्रता थी। दूसरी बात है राम के अंदर उत्साह था किसी भी कार्य को लेकर के, और आज्ञा पालन का गुण था, वह चाहे उनसे कोई छोटा हो चाहे उनसे कोई बड़ा हो, वो हर एक चीज को सकारात्मक रूप से देखते हैं। क्योंकि जब माता कैकेयी उन्हें वन जाने के लिए कहते हैं तो वो दशरथ को बताते हैं कि वन जाने से मुझे तमाम ऋषि मुनियों से मिलना होगा जिसके द्वारा मेरा ज्ञान अर्जन होगा और ज्ञान बढ़ेगा। तो क्या था राम के अंदर? राम के अंदर हर चीज को सकारात्मक रूप से लेकर चलने की अद्वितीय प्रतिभा थी, और यह रामायण को मूलभूत रूप से श्रेष्ठ बनाता है। धन्यवाद। मैं अपने वक्तव्य को ही समाप्त करता हूँ। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू सर। योर टाइम हैज बीन एक्सीडेड बाय 28 सेकंड्स। इट इज 3 मिनट्स एंड 28 सेकंड्स। थैंक यू फॉर योर स्पीच।
थैंक यू मिस्टर मयंक। वी नाउ मूव ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट मिस्टर अजय कुमार वर्मा, बनारस हिंदू यूनिवर्सिटी। नेक्स्ट वी हैव मानसी पाठक, सनबीम विमेंस कॉलेज, वरुणा। आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू काइंडली अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ एंड डिलीवर योर स्पीच।
थैंक यू। मे आई स्टार्ट?
यस।
यू कैन नॉट प्रोटेक्ट धर्म इफ यू डू नॉट नो what it is. Good afternoon and Jai Hind to the respected dignitaries. I'm Mansi Pathak from Sunbeam Women's College, Varna, here to deliver the speech in context of the given topic. Generations after generations, Ramayana have been the book that people have looked upon to learn the virtue, to lead their life and follow the dharma. The stories, shlokas and quotes are the treasure of knowledge which inspire people to lead the righteous and virtuous life. Ramayana has acted as a vehicle which reflects and carries the societal changes over the stories that exist. It shows that dharma is not just about religious practices but about living itself. Whereas on the path of modernization, we have lost our cultural values and have forgotten the principles it laid. So it becomes even more important for us to understand it today than it was before, inculcate and imbibe it. As Lord Ram and Lakshman portrayed the behavioral conduct that every man shall carry towards a woman in the society by their dharma, in today's era, it's very evident that men resemble traits of Ravan and not Ram. Ramayana also laid the foundation of ideal relationships by establishing the essence of brotherhood, unconditional love for family, trust, and will to do what is demanded. If we would have inculcated these values, we would have no existence of concepts like nuclear families, property disputes, crime against women since birth or old age homes. It's the law of dharma that a man has to repent and undergo punishment for the mistakes they make. As the fight between Ram and Ravan was the fight between dharma and adharma. Despite being educated, powerful, and the devotee of Lord Shiva, when Ravan began to follow the path of adharma, it became a necessity to kill the evil. Taking this into our lives, Ram and Ravan are the two sides of the same soul. So anything, anytime when the Ravan inside you begins to grow as means, proud, overambition, and cruelty, empower your Ram to conquer and kill the evil. At last, I would simply conclude it by saying that as each protagonist in the Ramayana stayed dedicated to their dharma, it shall be the impact of inculcation of the law of dharma that we shall stand as one when we fight for truth, making all possible efforts to resolve our issues before it becomes war, keeping our promises, making the right choices that one shall make on the path of dharma, as dharma shall prevail today, tomorrow, and forever. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Thank you, ma'am. Your total time taken was 2 minutes 59 seconds. Thank you for your speech.
We now move on to the next participant, Ms. Anisha Singh, Harishchand PG College. Ms. Anisha Singh. Moving on to the next, we have Alia Singh from Sri Agrasen Kanya PG College. Ms. Alia Singh.
Should I start?
Yes, you can start.
Okay. Dharma is not upheld by talking about it. It is upheld by living in harmony with it. It's a popular saying of Gautam Buddha. And the essence of these words can be drawn from the epic Ramayana. Ramayana, I think, needs no introduction, but I must speak. Hello, everyone. I'm Alia. I'm from Agrasen Kanya PG College. And today I'm here to deliver a speech on this very fascinating topic, role of dharma in Ramayana, its significance and impact in our modern life. Ramayana, one of the most greatest and immortal epic of India. It was composed several decades ago by Maharshi Valmiki. But through its universal and perennial source of knowledge, it continued to be relevant today, even more than before. Contrary to popular belief, what I believe, Ramayana is more than just a story. It teaches us dharma pertaining to the individual, family, society, or a nation as a whole. Its timeless values, its timeless moral, broadens our understanding, our consciousness, to me, from me, to we. Today, anarchy and corruption prevails in all walks of life, including business, politics, education. Then, teaching from Ramayana become more relevant. But what is the relevance of conducting fast, delivering a fascinating speech about its significance or its essence if we do not put it into practice? So what we need today is to incorporate those teachings into our own life. Because I strongly believe that intellect will blossom only when there is transformation. With these lines, I would like to sign off. Thank you so much for this opportunity.
Ma'am, your total time taken was 2 minutes, 2 seconds. Thank you for your speech.
Next, we have Mr. Sonial Bajaj, SGTB Khalsa College. Mr. Sonial Bajaj. Next, we have Mr. Rohan, Kirori Mal College, Delhi University.
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you're audible and visible.
Okay, wait, just let me set up my time limit, like stopwatch, then I will speak.
Sure, you can do that.
Okay. शुरू करते हैं.
Sure.
सभा की गरिमा को मेरा सादर नमन. मैं रोहन किरोडमल महाविद्यालय दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय के का छात्र आप सभी के समक्ष. महोदय, जो विषय है वो मूलतः है रामायण के ऊपर बात की जा रही है और कहीं ना कहीं रामायण के संदर्भ में जो धर्म है और जिसकी प्रासंगिकता है तो समझने की आवश्यकता है. जो रामायण है वह अपने आप में कृति है जो वाल्मीकि जी द्वारा रचित है. तो मूलतः जब हम किसी कृति की बात करते हैं तो कृति के अंदर कई नैतिक पहलू छिपे होते हैं और उन नैतिकता की प्रासंगिकता इस बात पर निर्भर करती है कि वर्तमान परिप्रेक्ष्य में उसकी पंक्ति के आखिरी खड़े व्यक्ति तक उसकी पहुंच है या नहीं है. जब हम बात करते हैं धर्म की तो धर्म अपने आप में एक व्यक्तिपरक अवधारणा है और जाहिर सी बात है धर्म व्यक्ति टू व्यक्ति डिफर करता है. लेकिन जब हम रामायण को देखते हैं तो रामायण में कहीं ना कहीं एक सर्वसमावेशी प्रकृति की जो झलक दिखती है. एक पुत्र के रूप में रामायण में धर्म के प्रति एक संवेदना दिखती है, वहीं एक पिता के रूप में भी दिखती है, एक पति के रूप में भी दिखती है और एक पत्नी के रूप में भी दिखती है. ये सभी पहलू कहीं ना कहीं दर्शाते हैं कि कैसे एक और एक भाई के रूप में भी, क्योंकि कहीं ना कहीं रावण जो भाई के रूप में अपने धर्म को परिलक्षित करता है. तो ये सभी जो है वो धर्म को तो दर्शाते हैं, लेकिन जब हम बात करते हैं विषय के परिप्रेक्ष्य में और वर्तमान के परिप्रेक्ष्य में तो समझने की आवश्यकता है कि वर्तमान परिप्रेक्ष्य में जो रामायण का धर्म है वो कैसे प्रासंगिक है. कि देखने की आवश्यकता है जब लंका और जो रामायण का युद्ध होता है, लंका युद्ध होता है, तो उससे पहले रामायण में जो श्री राम जी हैं वो अंगद को भेजते हैं दूत के रूप में. ये दर्शाता है कि जब आप युद्ध कर रहे हैं किसी दूसरे देश से तो आपके लिए आवश्यक हो जाता है कि आप अपनी कूटनीति को इस तरीके से रखें कि आप उस युद्ध को टाल दें. तो ये दर्शाता है कि वर्तमान परिप्रेक्ष्य में, भारतीय परिप्रेक्ष्य में कैसे भारत की जो विदेश नीति है वो भी इसी तरह से परिलक्षित होती है. अर्थात आप अचानक से युद्ध की परिणति नहीं रखते, आप पहले करते हैं क्या करते हैं कि आप अपने युद्ध को शांति के रूप में, एक सौहार्द के रूप में बात करने की बात करते हैं. फिर वही समझने की आवश्यकता है कि जो रामायण के परिप्रेक्ष्य में जो नारी चेतना का जो विमर्श होता है, अर्थात जो सीता माता दिखाती हैं कि किस तरीके से जो नारीवादी उपागम है वो एक पहलू है जो वस्तुतः भारतीय परिप्रेक्ष्य में 1960 के बाद यानी वैश्विक परिप्रेक्ष्य में दिखता है, वो कहीं ना कहीं दर्शाता है कि जो रामायण है वो एक न केवल एक राजनीतिक रूप से अपितु नारी विमर्श के रूप में भी सामने आता है और वही कहीं ना कहीं एक पिता रूप में, पुत्र रूप में, पति रूप में और साथ ही साथ भाई रूप में, पत्नी रूप में, माता रूप में भी परिलक्षित होता है. अर्थात उन सभी धर्मों को एक सर्वसमावेशी प्रकृति के रूप में वर्तमान में आवश्यकता है जो कि नैतिकता के रूप में किसी भी व्यक्ति विशेष के अंदर समाहित की जा सकती है, बशर्ते केवल देखने से नहीं अपितु उसके व्यवहारिक जीवन में भी लागू होना है. अगर वह लागू होता है तो कहीं ना कहीं भारतीय परिप्रेक्ष्य में जो घटनाएं घट रही हैं, अर्थात जो अनैतिक जो कृत्य हो रहे हैं वो कहीं ना कहीं खत्म हो, इसके लिए आवश्यक है. वस्तुतः हम सुनते भी हैं कि कक्षा 6 क्लास में हमें रामायण पढ़ाई जाती है एनसीईआरटी में, लेकिन आवश्यक बात यह है कि उनको व्यवहारिक रूप से व्यक्ति विशेष के अंदर लाया जाए, तभी वह विचार या जो वस्तु विशेष इकाई है वो प्रासंगिक हो पाएंगे. क्योंकि आपके लिए केवल अध्ययन एक प्रासंगिकता नहीं होती, आपके लिए आवश्यक हो जाता है कि आप उन सभी पहलुओं को व्यक्ति के जीवन में उतारें और साथ साथ उनके लिए एक प्रैक्टिकली रूप से, लाइक प्रैक्टिकली आप प्रयोग करें, तब जाके वह कोई विशेष व्यक्ति जो विशेष विचार है वो प्रासंगिक हो पाता है. और कोई जो विचार जो लंबे समय से चलता आ रहा है अगर वह प्रासंगिक आज भी है तो कहीं ना कहीं समाज के जो स्ट्रक्चर है उसके अंदर कुछ ना कुछ खामियां हैं. तो इसके लिए समझने की आवश्यकता कि जो रामायण का जो कृति है वो विचार आज भी प्रासंगिक है, वस्तुतः इसके लिए व्यावहारिक जीवन में लागू करने की आवश्यकता है. धन्यवाद.
सर, योर टोटल टाइम टेकन वाज 3 minutes 2 seconds. यू हैव एक्सीडेड योर टाइम बाय 2 seconds. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर स्पीच.
नेक्स्ट वी हैव मिस्टर अभियंकर, किरोरीमाल कॉलेज. मिस्टर अभियंकर. नेक्स्ट वी हैव तृप्ति बाइसन, MIT Academy of Engineering. Tripti. Next we have Mr. Ayush Thakur, Motilal Nehru College, Delhi University. Mr. Ayush Thakur.
Meri awaaz aa rahi hai aap sabko?
Yes, you are audible.
Kuch ek second. Ab theek hai? Dikh raha hu main. आप मुझे देख पा रहे हैं?
I request you to kindly be a bit more loud.
अब ठीक है, आवाज आ रही है?
हाँ, बिल्कुल आ रही है. आप शुरू कर सकते हैं.
सदन की गरिमा को सादर नमन, आप सभी को जय सियाराम. जैसा कि आज का विषय है रामायण और उसमें आज की प्रासंगिकता, तो रामायण हम हमेशा राम के आसपास ढूंढ रहे होते हैं, मगर आवश्यकता है राम के साथ जो उनके आसपास के और भी चरित्र हैं उन पर बात करने की. तुलसीदास ने रामचरितमानस लिखा, मगर वही मैथिली शरण गुप्त ने लिखा साकेत, जो कि उर्मिला के बेसिस पे लिखा गया है. उसी तरीके के और भी लोग हैं जो कि हमें इस विषय पर बात करते हुए दिखते हैं. जितने लोग हैं, जैसे भरत हैं, कैकई है, सीता है, हनुमान, दशरथ, लक्ष्मण, रावण, हम सबसे कुछ ना कुछ सीख सकते हैं। जब कौशल्या से सबसे बड़ी सीखने वाली बात है, जब एक प्रसंग है साकेत में जहां पर कौशल्या कहती है कई 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 से, होने पर बहुधा अर्धरात अंधेरी, जी जी आकरती पुकार थी तेरी, लोको कुहुकनी अपना कुहुक राम है जागा, निज मझली माँ का स्वप्न देख है जागा। यहाँ पे संवेदना देखिए कितना महत्वपूर्ण है कि जब कैकई को आप इतने होने के बाद भी कह के रिग्रेट कर रही हैं कि मेरे से ये कितनी बड़ी गलती हो गई है। उसी तरीके से भरत की जो निष्ठा है, जो अपने कर्तव्य के प्रति निष्ठा है और जो अपनी भ्रातृ प्रेम की ओर निष्ठा है, वो दोनों को संतुलित भाव से लेकर किस प्रकार से चला जाता है, ये भरत से सीखने योग्य बात है। वहीं कहीं ना कहीं अंगद से जो लीडरशिप क्वालिटी है, जो हम सीखते हैं कि एक अंतरराष्ट्रीय नीति किस तरह से अपनाई जाती है, जब अंगद पहुंचते हैं रावण के दरबार में तो किस तरीके से अंगद बात कहते हैं वो महत्वपूर्ण है। रावण पूछते हैं अंगद से कि तुम्हें पता है मैं कौन हूं, और अंगद का जो जवाब है वो हर एम्बेसडर को सीखने योग्य है कि अंगद कहते हैं कि हाँ मुझे पता है कि तुम मेरे पिता बाली से हारे थे, और वो जो डेफिनेशन है वो कहीं ना कहीं अपने में बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है। सुग्रीव की जो मित्रता है, बहुत आसान था सुग्रीव के लिए, राम के द्वारा राम जी ने सुग्रीव की मदद कर दी थी और सुग्रीव उसके बाद उन्हें छोड़ सका, जो मित्रता है वह महत्वपूर्ण है। तो इसी तरीके से इन सभी चरित्रों का कहीं ना कहीं मिश्रण है श्री राम में, और वो नैतिकता हमेशा प्रासंगिक ही रहेगी क्योंकि नैतिकता बदलती नहीं है। व्यक्ति तो व्यक्ति, उसकी नैतिकता और धर्म का की परिभाषा जरूर बदलती है, मगर व्यक्ति कितना बेहतरीन और अच्छा हो सकता है इस पर हम कभी बदलाव नहीं देख सकते हैं। इसीलिए रामायण की हर एक पंक्ति, हर एक चरित्र, हर एक पात्र, चाहे वो नायक के रूप में हो या खलनायक के रूप में हो, वो सब आज के परिवेश में प्रासंगिक है क्योंकि उनमें से कोई भी व्यक्तित्व आज हमारे जीवन में मौजूद नहीं है और ना ही वो व्यक्तित्व मौजूद है। व्यक्ति तो छोड़िए, व्यक्तित्व भी हमारे अंदर मौजूद है। इसलिए आवश्यकता है कि हम राम सभी चरित्रों को अपने अंदर बसाने की कोशिश करें। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद
सर। योर टोटल टाइम टेकन वाज 2 minutes 30 seconds। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर स्पीच।
नेक्स्ट वी हैव मिस उदीशा यादव, सनबीम कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन, भगवानपुर। मिस उदीशा यादव, we have taken the names of all the participants, just in case anyone has joined late you can inform us about that. I can see Mr. Sonial Bajaj, SGTB Khalsa College, he is present. Can you hear me?
Yes ma'am, I can hear you.
Okay, so now it's your time to deliver the speech. I hope you are ready. Your sure. time starts yeah. now.
All right. Thank you for the recognition. Honorable Chair and members of the House, my greetings to one and all. Today, in my three-minute speech, I would extensively like to enlighten you on the law of Dharma and its significance and impact in the modern times. Ladies and gentlemen, before I take you on a mythological ride to the context, I would like to ask you, does this House believe that the law of Dharma is all about righteousness of action or conduct? If that's so, if Google has made you believe that's the reason, I think there's more to it, ladies and gentlemen. So to your surprise, I'd like to let you know that Dharma is a decision-making process that enables you to discover your humanity, and it exists in the context of karma. Flipping through the pages of history, let me tell you, one realizes that in the forest, animals follow the law of the jungle. That is that the big fish eats the smaller fish. But if the same happens in the human society, if the stronger starts dominating over the poor, the rich starts dominating over the poor, that's adharma, and that's completely the opposite of it. But is this really relevant in the present society when the capitalistic nature of the society completely suppresses the downtrodden? We need to embrace their problems and take them forward rather than sidelining them altogether. But ladies and gentlemen, to a paradox, today we live in a world where Twitter and politicians tell us what to do and what not to do. We don't have a guru like Guru Dronacharya, but we have our one only guru, that's Google, our guru Google. And it nowhere talks about the intersection of Vishwas, Itihas, and Vigyan. We have been born with a tendency to focus just on science and evidence-based truth, but we somewhere don't realize the fact that
we are not being told the right things in the complex world which we are living in. We are not really being told about different things. How are the intersection of mythology and fact finding is concerned, and therefore a person like me, a youth like me, gets lost in number of definitions available on the net and turns out to make another definition of its own. Certainly, what I'd like to let you know all is that dharma is based on the principle of rationality. It says that you need not follow a particular rule just for the sake of it blindly, but like rational beings. It also talks about Vasudev Kutumbakam. The world is a family. And in times of a pandemic like this, when everyone comes together, when United Nations and everyone calls for people to come together, this very fact states that dharma is very much relevant, but the youth of the country doesn't realize this, rather focuses much on science-based evidence and stuff like that. Therefore, one needs to understand that in these testing times, it's dharma that's holding the mankind together, and that can create a lot of difference in the society. With this, I'd like to conclude my speech. Thank you so much for your patient hearing.
Sir, your total time taken was 3 minutes, 26 seconds. You have exceeded the time limit by 26 seconds. Thank you so much for your speech.
Thank you, everyone. I hope we have heard all the speakers. In case anyone has joined us late, you can inform us. So with this, we come to the end of Ramayan Vyakhyan speech competition. Thanks a lot to each of the participants. We gained a lot of valuable insights from your speech, and I do believe that the audience also believes the same. Now, our judge would be deciding the results for this competition. But meanwhile, we will be declaring the results of all the 3 submission-based events. We received an overwhelming participation from different colleges in India. Firstly, I would declare the results for Ramayan Chaupai. The event was judged by Dr. Chandra Prabha Gupta, Assistant Professor of Harish Chandra PG College, Varanasi. The first prize goes to Ms. Yashaswini Shukla of Sunbeam Women's College, Varuna. Congratulations for your amazing performance. Second, we have Mr. Himanshu Mishra, Birla Institute of Technology, Ms. Congratulations, Himanshu. You were melodious and we were glad to receive your participation. Third, we have Akansha Pandey from Sri Ganesh Rai PG College. You were indeed articulate. Thanks to all our winners and also to all our participants. We really value your participation and we were glad to receive it. Over to Divya to announce the results of the next competition, Ramayan Chitran.
Ramayan Chitran, the art competition. The event was judged by Dr. Mandakini Gupta, Assistant Professor at Sunbeam Women's College, Varuna. And the first prize goes to Ms. Shweta Verma from Sunbeam Women's College, Varuna. Many, many congratulations to you, Shweta. Second prize goes to Ms. Sanjana from Janki Devi Memorial College, University of Delhi. Congratulations, Sanjana. Your painting was truly mesmerizing. And the third prize goes to Ms. Anshika Sahu, DAV PG College, Dehradun. Good luck for your future efforts. Congratulations, everyone.
Next, we have the winners of Ramayan Lake Youth. The event was judged by Dr. Nidhi Mishra, Assistant Professor of Mahila Mahavidyalay, BHU. The first prize goes to Ms. Divya Chaudhary, Sunbeam Women's College, Varuna, who is also the host for today's Ramayan Festival. Congratulations, Divya. The second prize goes to Ms. Rashi Baranwal, Sunbeam Women's College, Varuna. Congratulations, Ms. Rashi. The third prize goes to Ms. Nikita Rajpurohit from Mount Carmel College, Bangalore. Nikita composed a very beautiful poetry in Hindi and we were very glad to read it. Thanks a lot for your participation. Congratulations to all the winners. Now, it's time for all of you to kindly go to your chat boxes and access a link that would be provided in a minute. Before that, can we have the videos of all the participants who were there in the Chaupai competition, all the winners? Yes. So here is the video by our first position holder, Ms. Yashaswini Shukla. These virtual meetings have actually taught us to be patient because a lot of times there are technical problems. Sir, can you give a confirmation if that is possible, or we would move further and we can do it later if it it has some problem right now.
I think we have been facing a glitch. In the meanwhile, you can just share the Google form so that participants can fill up the form in the meanwhile. We'll try to reconnect it in the same time.
Sure, ma'am. So we will surely try to show all the winning videos to all of you. Till then, since your feedback is extremely valuable to us, so I will be sharing the feedback form link in the chat box in a minute. Kindly access it and do fill the feedback form. After that, we will be resuming to the Ramayan Vyakhyan session and the results will be declared. I am sharing the form in a minute. Your feedback. And also implement any sort of suggestions in the next event that we conduct.
Well, we thank you all for being such a patient listener. Just a minute late, we'll just be coming up with the results of the same. Smriti, you can continue. We are there with the result.
Okay, ma'am. So we resume to the Ramayan Vyakhyan event. Our judge, Dr. Priyanka Srivastav, has joined us with the results. But ma'am, before we move on to the declaration of results, I would like you to please throw light on the Ramayan Vyakhyan event and also give your feedback to our participants. And once we are done with your speech, we'll be moving on to the results.
Thank you, Smriti. It was highly commendable session. Participant, it was pleasure hearing you all. I heard all the participants very carefully and tried to present or to be impartial. All superbly expressed themselves, presented themselves very well, and no doubt it was a studious and insightful presentation by all. Many takeaways were there. Everybody's effort was praiseworthy. And I would like to give my feedback on this Vyakhyan. Let's start from Yashi. Yashi ki ek baat mujhe jo bahut achhi lagi, usne Sita ke character ko feminism se jod ke dikhaya. Sita jo ki drid sankalpit rahi aur निर्णय लेने की जो उन्होंने उनकी जो क्षमता थी, उन्होंने अपना निर्णय स्वयं लिया कि उनको लाइफ को किस तरफ लीड करना है। मैंने दूसरे पार्टिसिपेंट मयंक के बारे में बात करूंगी। उन्होंने रावण के कैरेक्टर पे फोकस किया और उन्होंने ये कहा कि वो व्यभिचारी नहीं था, दृढ़ संकल्पित था, और उन्होंने मीन्स ही लेड अ वेरी वर्चुअस लाइफ इन दिस रिगार्ड दैट ही इवन नेवर टच्ड सीता, इफ ही वांटेड ही कुड डू एनीथिंग। अभी मानसिक पे आते हैं, थर्ड पार्टिसिपेंट थी मानसी। उन्होंने बात करी कि वी शुड, अकॉर्डिंग टू मानसी, we should learn the virtue to lead life, and this virtue should be inculcated through reading the Ramayana. Alia, who was the fifth participant, she talked of incorporating the teaching of the Ramayana in our lives. Rohan talked of the dharma, the character of the Ramayana. Dharma should possess, and dharma according to रोहन मीन्स डीड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी। आयुष ठाकुर ने बात करी कि राम के साथ साथ दूसरे जो चरित्र हैं, जैसे कौशल्या का चरित्र है, संवेदनशीलता उनके अंदर है, भरत का जो की जो निष्ठा है और उनका भातृप्रेम है, अंगद का जो नेतृत्व कौशल है, और सुग्रीव की मित्रता को हमें लेना चाहिए और सीखना चाहिए। सोनियाल बजाज ने ही टॉक्ड ऑफ द लॉ ऑफ धर्मा, who relates to karma. तो धर्म का मतलब कर्म ही है, सोनियाल बजाज ने ऐसा कहा। और in this way, I think I have given the feedback of all the participants. The worst thing was this, that most of the participants crossed the time limit. That's why result totally changed. Okay. Thank you so much. Best wishes to all the participants. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable feedback. The students, the participants would surely gain a lot from it. Now, before we announce the results for Ramayana Vyakhyan, here's a story that I would like to tell all of you. Ramayana is often called as the first poem in the world of literature as per Hindu tradition. So there's a story behind how it actually came into being. And Maharshi Valmiki is also called as Adi Kavya, the first poet. So here's the story about it. Maharshi Valmiki questioned Devarshi Narad, who exists at present in this world, who has all qualities and virtues. In response, Devarshi Narad told Maharshi Valmiki about Shri Ram. Later, Maharshi Valmiki went to Tamsa River with Bharadwaj. There he saw a crane couple adoring each other. Suddenly, an arrow shot the male crane dead. The female crane grieved at this pitiful sight. Valmiki was extremely sad to witness this sorrowful event. He angrily uttered words addressing the hunter who had shot the arrow. What he said actually meant, "You will never attain peace and rest because you have killed the male of this pair while they made love." Later, Valmiki realized that what he had said was arranged to follow a meter and was viable for rendition in the form of a song. This is how the first poetry of the world as per Hindu tradition and the first poem of Sanskrit literature came into being. Now it's finally the time to move on to the results of Ramayana Vyakhyan speech competition. Now, I would request our judge, Dr. Priyanka Srivastav, to kindly announce the winners of this competition.
Now here, I'm with the result. The third position goes to Ms. Alia Singh from Sri Agasen Kanya PG College with 8.5 points. The second place has been secured by Ayush Thakur with 9 points. And the third and the first position, I'm so sorry. The third position goes to Alia Singh. The second goes to Ayush Thakur with 9 points. And the first goes to Mansi Pathak of Sunbeam Women College, Varanasi, with 9.5 points. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Congratulations to all the winners. And also congratulations to all the participants. What you learned here anyway matters more than any other certificate or winning positions. We therefore congratulate everyone who joined us. Now, I would also like to extend our thanks to Dr. Deepthi Agarwal and Dr. Pooja Singh for the organization of this event. Hari Anant, Hari Katha Ananta, Kahi So Nahi, Bahubidhi Sab Santa. Lord is infinite and his glories are infinite. Every saint sings and hears them in divergent ways. With this, we take your leave. Stay safe. And also, we would like to inform you that since we were not able to play the winning videos here, so we will be sharing all of the winning entries on our social media pages. Do follow us on Sunbeam Women's College Varuna on Facebook as well as on Instagram. We look forward to having you in all the future events that we conduct. Till then, stay safe. Thanks a lot for joining us. Congratulations to each of the winners and participants. See you then. Jai Hind.
And the certificates will be shared within 12 hours to the mentioned email ID on the application. Thank you and Jai Hind.
I would request Shubhkamna if you can write the college Facebook in the chat box.
Sure, ma'am. We are sharing the link of our college Facebook on the chat option. We have shared the link in the chat option. Kindly follow us on the Facebook to know more about the college fairs coming ahead.